Hi everyone, so welcome to another surgery lecture in the series Principles of Surgery. Many a times you will find cases in your clinics or hospitals, there will be some swelling in some part of the body, there will be swelling. You have to differentiate whether this is a tumor or cyst or abscess or a hernia. So you should know what is the characteristics of tumor, cyst, abscess and hernia so that you can differentiate and you can tell the owner that what is the condition. In this class, we will discuss in detail about tumor, cyst, abscess and hernia. After this class, you will be able to tell your owner confidently that whether this is a cyst, abscess, tumor or hernia. Before going to the video, please subscribe to the channel. There will be a subscribe button. It is kind of moral support for me because now 75% of watchers are still not subscribing. So let us start our class. First one is tumor. You see, I have taken a referral example. All the cases are from the abdomen. Okay, you will find the swelling in abdominal region because it will be easy to compare. Okay, a cyst can happen in an abdominal region or thoracic region or even in leg or something, but I have taken a referral example so that you can understand. Principle is same so that you can understand it in a better way. First one is, you see, first let me tell you the diagrams. You see this purple line, okay, this purple line, this one is peritoneum, the green line is muscle, and the orange line is skin. Between the muscle and skin there is subcutaneous tissue. All the diagrams represent the same. Now first one is tumor. Tumor is nothing but uncontrolled multiplication or uncontrolled proliferation of cells. Now the structure of tumor, usually you will find a capsule. This one, the outer one, the orange one is a capsule. You see here the capsule represents the covering. Okay, this does not mean that there will be a capsule. Okay, so in some tumors you may not find a capsule, especially in malignant ones you may not find a capsule. So for your reference, for easy understanding, this one is a capsule and the inner one will be cells, or you can say tissue. Okay, this is structure. Remember, in tumor the boundary is not fixed. Okay, it can keep growing over time, it will keep growing. The rate may vary, some tumor grow very fast, some are little bit slow, but they will keep growing. Now what are the contents you will find? Usually cells. Okay, now remember, I will go for tumor in the next class. There will I will be telling in detail about tumors. Tumors can be benign and malignant. In benign tumors, usually the OMA suffix is used, where in case of malignant, sarcoma suffix. Suppose there is a tumor of fibrous tissue. If it is a benign one, it will be fibroma. If it is a malignant one, then fibrosarcoma. Okay. Next class, I will tell in detail about tumors. Now coming to cyst. First, what is a cyst? Cyst is a cavity containing fluid. Usually it is fluid. Now the structure, you see the outer one, the skin is capsule. Okay, you see this blue line, this blue line is SM or secreting membrane. This membrane secretes this fluid. The entire fluid is being secreted by this secreting membrane. Now the inner one is basically fluid which is usually exudates. This is not your eggs. Exudates. So the boundary is usually fixed. You see why I am telling usually? Most of them it is fixed, but in some cases where there is trauma to cyst, the already existing cyst, it may increase in size, but usually they are fixed. It does not grow like tumor. Okay, they are usually fixed. Now what are the contents? You will find straw colored liquid. Most of the time you will find liquid, in sometimes semi-solid. When in a long standing cases, it may become semi-solid, or you may find some fibrin clots. This is cyst. And for students who are who will be appearing viva voice, these are some short questions which are usually asked by the external examination. Ranula is basically the cyst of sublingual salivary gland. Okay, the sublingual salivary gland opens on the side of frenum linguae. The middle one is frenum linguae. So if there will be any blockage to the duct, there will be cyst formation, accumulation of saliva, there will be cyst. This is known as ranula. Ranula is a retention cyst. Now the dentigerous cyst, it means denti means from teeth. Okay, this one is found in case of horses. This is very very rare cases, but they may act in as a objective type questions. So it is found in horses. What happens? Usually teeth is found in oral cavity. Sometimes the teeth may found in temporal bone. So around the teeth there will be cyst formation. Okay, and it will drain out just at the base of the ear. Okay, that is known as dentigerous cyst. Honey cyst, it is mostly found in case of dogs. Very very rare condition. Okay, it is due to the faulty branchial plexus or non-joining of branchial plexus. This is all about the cyst. Now coming to the abscess. What is abscess? Abscess is basically any cavity containing pus. Pus is nothing but dead polymorphic cells, usually neutrophils. Now the structure is here. You see the orange one is the capsule or skin. Next you will find pyogenic membrane. You see, this is not like the secreting membrane. Here it secretes the fluid, while this one is just a name given to this membrane. You see, if you will take a histological section of this one, first there will be skin and there will be a layer where you will find the degenerative changes. This layer was named as pyogenic membrane. It doesn't mean that this pyogenic membrane will secrete pus. Okay, so pyogenic membrane and the content will be pus. This one has a fixed boundary. Most of the time, usually or maximum time, you will find the fixed boundary. It does not grow over time, and the content are usually white in color, and it may be liquid, semi-solid. These two are very common one. You may find liquid pus or semi-solid pus. Solid, when in long standing cases, the fluid portion will get absorbed so that it becomes a solid. Now the abscess has three stages. First one is formation, when there will be abscess formation. Ripening, it means what will happen, this pus usually moves around. Okay, so where, suppose this one is the thinnest part. Okay, what will happen, it will become more and more thinner. You will find like a point is appearing. You see, this pointing is not always gravity dependent. Okay, it does not mean that it will only appear where because of gravity. It may appear here, may appear here. Okay, if it is happening in anti-gravity places, then you have to give a counter opening to drain. Okay, now here is a pointing. This pointing is known as ripening, and this is a very characteristics to abscess. After some days, this becomes so thin that it could not handle this pressure and it will rupture, and here there will be drainage of pus. The third stage, rupture. Okay, this is a characteristics of abscess. Now some short questions external might ask, or you may get objective type questions. Antibioma. What is antibioma? Suppose this is a abscess. Okay, and as a clinician, suppose you did not diagnose that this is a abscess, you may take it as some inflammatory swelling. What will happen? You will give antibiotics and anti-inflammatories. Suppose you are giving antibiotic or anti-inflammatory for long period of time, what will happen? This capsule will become fibrosed. Okay, in long standing cases, and this pus, the fluid portion will be completely absorbed and it become very hard. That situation is known as the antibioma. Now acne is basically the pus formation in your sebaceous gland. You may find in your own face also. Now these three, the impetigo, the furunculosis and carbuncle, they are basically the staphylococcal infections. this is a bacteria, post forming bacteria, Staphylococcus. So impetigo, you will find pustules all over your body. You see difference between the vesicle and pustule. Remember, the vesicle is a thin membrane with clear fluid. Okay, when it becomes when the fluid becomes pus, it is pustules. Now furunculosis, furunculosis is basically pustules, but involving the hair particle. And when it involves the hair particle, it's known as boil. Okay, you will find boils all over the body. Carbuncle, it is actually small form of boil where there is very less drainage. It may find small spots all over your body through which there will be inadequate drainage. These are nothing but staphylococcal infections. Okay. Now coming to the hernia. You see, hernia is a separate chapter. I will discuss in when I will go for the systemic surgery. I will discuss about hernia. There is a classification of hernia. It comes as a long question in your examination. So we will discuss only the important one from the differentiating point of view. Now the hernia. You see, hernia is basically protrusion of organ through opening. It may be natural opening or traumatic opening. So let us go to the structure. The structure is very important. Okay. Now you see here the purple lines, the peritoneum. Okay. In any of the thing, any of the condition where the tumor cyst or abscess, you may not find any interference with the muscle and the peritoneum. Here, what will happen? There will be some small opening in the muscle. You see, this green line is muscle. You see, there is some opening. Okay. See, it may be a natural opening like inguinal canal, or it may be a traumatic opening. Here, I have taken this as traumatic opening. Now, here is a peritoneum. So, what will happen through this muscle opening? The intestinal, usually it is intestine or any organ, they will protrude. So along with protrusion, they will take away the, they will bring the peritoneum. Okay, so what will the structure? Capsule, the skin. Okay, then you will find the peritoneal membrane, then you will find the content as organ. Okay, the usually the contents are organs. It may be intestine, sometimes you may find bladder, okay, stomach, etc. There are many more things I will discuss when I will discuss hernia. Now here remember another thing, hernia has three parts. This one, this opening is known as hernial ring. Okay, and this sac known as hernial sac, and this inner one known as hernial content. Okay, and also you will find some parts dividing the hernia, like this one is a neck, this portion. Okay, this is body, and this is as fundus. Okay, but you may not find this one. Okay, mostly it's hernial ring, hernial sac, and hernial content. So this is all about the tumor, cyst, abscess and hernia. Now how we'll diagnose this one? Okay, when you are finding any swelling, first differentiate the hernia. Okay, why? I will tell later. So first you will palpate hernia. Usually you can push this hernial content inside the abdomen and you can feel this ring. You see, hernia can be reducible hernia and irreducible hernia. Okay, irreducible hernia usually happens in long standing case, but if it is a fresh case, you may not find the irreducible hernia. I will discuss reducible, irreducible in hernia class. Okay, so what will happen? You will push this content, it will easily go back into the abdomen and you can feel this hernial ring. Then you can tell this one is hernia. When it is differentiated, let us assume that you palpated and it's not a hernia. Now comes these three, the tumor, the cyst and abscess. For these three, you have to do a needle puncture test. Okay. You see, in case of why I told you that first you should differentiate the hernia. If you are doing needle puncture test in this one, you may injure the organ. Okay. But if you are using fine needle, it may not injure, but still it may injure this internal contents or organs. That is why first diagnose the hernia, whether this is hernia or not, then do this one. So when you will do the needle puncture test, so in case of tumor, you will find blood coming through the needle. In case of cyst, you will find a fluid which is straw colored. In case of abscess, you will find pus. Okay, this is a very simple test. Now this is a tricky part. When the tumor grows, okay, when it will go on increasing in size, okay, suppose you imagine this is increasing in size, what will happen? The blood vessel usually supply to the periphery. Okay, the blood vessel supply to the central part is hampered. What will happen to the central part? The cells will be dead and there will be necrosis and it will be filled with some fluid, or it may be filled with pus. Okay, so when you will be doing the needle puncture test, okay, suppose your needle passed through tumor and entered the central area of necrosis or central necrotic area, you may tell that this one is an abscess, you are finding some necrotic tissue. Okay, so you have to be very careful. So you have to take the history, okay, the history of no fixed boundary, it keeps on growing. While abscess, it does not grow over time, but a tumor, they grow over time. This is a tricky part. I have seen 2-3 cases, okay, especially you will find in mammary tumors, okay, in case of dogs, in mammary tumors, you may find one surgery video, you can find there the central area of necrosis where there will be the pus or fluid accumulation, necrotic tissue fluid accumulation. So you may get confused. Okay, so this is all about the tumor, cyst, abscess and hernia. I hope you have got the idea regarding differentiating between the cyst, tumor, abscess and hernia. So this is all about today's class. In next class we will go for tumor and chemotherapy. Thank you for watching. See you. Bye-bye. Stay safe.